And passenger Karpovsky. Nothing.
You know we had to pull up with the Duncan. Dunkies. Gang. What up? You know we had to bring back the vlog. What up, DJ Toasty Z? You know I had to bring back the vlog. Glad. What up, DJ Toasty Z? You know I had to bring back the vlog. You already know what it is. Been gone, camera broke, but we're back with the vlogs. And started off with a very special episode. I'm actually in Logan International Airport in Boston. About to fly out to Los Angeles. Toasty Takes LA Part 2. We got a lot of great things in the works. Got some artist interviews lined up. Podcasts. There's even some shows I'm gonna head out to. It's gonna be a blast. I'm really looking forward to it. I'm gonna save some surprises for you though. Keep it locked.
You might catch me in Atlanta, looking like a boss. New Orleans and then Miami, party in New York. Texas, I be screwed up. Chi-town, I be really pimping. But nothing like my hometown. Now forever living. Look me in
Atlanta. They come for.
To pull up on my man Toasty, or Toasty had to pull up on me. We're out here in the left coast now. Englewood had to come pull up on, you know, the land of Paul Pierce and all that. But
isn't that beautiful?
It's even more beautiful outside. We're just in the crib right now. But shout out to my man Toasty. Have fun in LA. Enjoy yourself. I know you're gonna get busy out here. And welcome to the left coast. Welcome to California.
You already know. Shout out Fresh Out the Mint. You know, they're doing big things as well. Go check them out if you don't know. If you ain't hip to the gang, look at this. I'm hip to the game. You should be too.
Fresh Out the Mint, man.
You already know. Gang, gang. About to finally do this Louis Go podcast.
Y'all already know, man. Y'all already know what it is. Fucking lay lay. Fucking Toasty Z in the motherfucking building, you heard?
You already know.
Sorry, excuse me.
Got a Toasty vlog back. Back in action.
Oh
God!
Let's see where it's blue. It's good.
All right, it's so the music's starting.
I do.
All right, fuck my phone drop. Louis Go, it's here.
Hey. Cash forever.
All right, this is the pod. We're officially started the podcast. Louis Go.
Let's get it.
We're recording now. Here.
Should I put on the Don? Take off Don Kennedy.
Turn off Don Kennedy.
Fuck me, I'm down.
All right, so turn that. We need to get focused. You gotta turn up.
It's got me and Livia are like blood.
Yeah.
Like I told her the concept of my album and she drew exactly what I needed, bro. Like she drew
She's an amazing artist. Oh, the cap's on. I'm trying to pour the cap.
Yeah. That's what he's saying. That's a year moment.
Look at the audio, it's so fucked up.
Yo.
We're about 37 minutes
in. Let's get it. But like, yo, I want to take a segment of this.
I feel like when you try and pour with the cap on, that's when you know you should stop drinking.
Yo, facts. I would say maybe though.
Gang, gang.
Huzzah!
I know we had a pull up.
Tuna
milk.
You don't even know what time it is, dude.
The details in your beard. It's immaculate.
Thanks.
What up, vlog? Sorry, I haven't been giving you good updates, but we've been doing a lot of content, recording a lot of content. So my camera has died a couple times. Haven't been able to fill in the vlog footage. So Saturday night we did the Louis Go Drunken podcast. We got a little too drunken, if you know what I mean. We never ended up making it. We're gonna go to the Ham on Everything show. Ham on Everything show afterwards. And unfortunately, I don't think we have the autofocus on. Unfortunately, it was like 1 o'clock by the time we finished and we were drunk and we're like, it's gonna be a disaster if we try and make it over there. So that didn't happen. Then Sunday I linked up with 720 Tony. Out in downtown LA. DJ Toasty Z, Hip Hop Made Me Do It. You already know. We're chilling with Tony, creator of 720. We're in downtown LA. We found a nice alleyway, you know, perfect for the spirit of 720. How's it going today, dude?
Doing good, thank you. Thanks, Toasty.
Yeah, of course.
It's an honor. I'm so psyched to do this.
Yeah, I'm excited too. I know you've talked about kind of like having this location as kind of a hub to like, you know, and, you know, foster community and collaboration with individuals. I'm curious, like, what kind of, I kind of got distracted by that guy walking by. We talked about everything he's done with 720, just the whole movement. Told some very interesting stories about, you know, what's happened as part of the collective and what's happened in the space. So super excited for that. Put that out. And we're going, like I said, we're going to link up with Louis Go again. And tonight, heading to Rosecrans Radio. And looking forward to that as well.
How many bands, yeah, I won't show your hand, no. Hey, it's all part of the plan, yeah. I'm thugging the fans, yeah. Hey, I keep it 100, yeah. Why does it keep stopping, bro? I got the energy, though.
Here we go, bro.
You know what I mean? You should do, like, this stuff, shots like this. That'd be sick. That's some little B-video shit, you know? All right, let's get it. Hey. Yeah. I'ma do what I gotta do. Hey. She played my heart like I was a fool. Before we started, it was beautiful. Hey, and the night is young and you coming through. I said, let's get out. What's it best? I'ma do what I gotta do. She played my heart like I was a fool.
I was like, where are you going?
Before we started, it was beautiful. I'ma do what I gotta do. She played my heart like I was a fool.
Louis Go.
Louis Go in nature, bitch.
Louis Go in nature. The one yellow flower.
Wow, that's beautiful. I'm gonna rip that shit apart. So scary. You think I'll jump?
You can't even see him.
Nah, that's a really good dog. We out here shooting today. Shout out Goon Von Doom. Toasty Z, Hip Hop Made Me Do It. We run on Dunkin', bitch. Ooh, is that the Japan? Oh, yeah.
Rosecrans Radio. We're live on Dash Radio's XXL station. I'm Rosecrans Vic. Got Cypress Moreno on the turntables. Giggles Irina's in the building. And we have a special guest here today. He's a member of the Break Bread Posse.
Yeah.
He's from the 562 and the Inland Empire.
Yeah.
He just got back from murdering several stages at South by Southwest.
Hell yeah.
His alias is Baby Rip Good.
Hell yeah. What's going on, man?
What's good, bro?
Chilling.
How you feeling?
I'm doing all right. What about you?
Shit, man, I'm good.
Because Tech hit me and was like, I got you. He hit me on Twitter and was like, Triz, I see you. That's all he said That's all he said. And then, like, two whole years go by. Like, two, 3 whole years go by. No messages from them or nothing. Lynch find out who I was. He flew me out to Kansas City. I get to Kansas City. I meet the rest of Strange Music. And the rest is history. And, like, I'm about, matter of fact, I got anytime Tech or any Strange Music tour come to LA, I got first dibs on that. On everything, like, if they can hit me, I can hit them up, like, yo, I'm trying to get on any of the LA dates or any of the California dates, for sure, we're gonna hit you back, boom.
We have a car enthusiast, a veteran in the game. He's also known as Real Deal Pete. It's Polyester the Saint.
What's up, what's up?
What's good with you, bro?
Yep, I'm good.
How you living?
Real good. It's more of like a family thing, so I've never really played in my music or anything like that, but a few years ago, he needed somebody to engineer, so he had me come, and I got to record him, you know, working on a song, playing harmonica and stuff like that. So that was like big for me.
That's dope.
Yeah. That's super legendary.
Yeah.
You need to put that in your Twitter bio. Like, engineered for Stevie Wonder. Like, that's it. You don't need to include anything else. Like, just engineered for Stevie Wonder. Like,
I mean, it was one time, but yeah. You know.
Still counts.
Beyonce, pregnant pants. They brought me these jeans with, like, elastic bands, and they're like, we have like 12 hours and we need them, like, completely distressed. And, like, if you've ever distressed jeans before, you know you're just sitting there, like, picking threads, like, one by one.
Yeah.
So it was my intern and I just sitting there all night long scratching at jeans, like, and we're just like, and I remember I took them out of the wash and they looked like shit, but she had to get on a plane. I was like, they're gonna be mad at me, like,
yeah.
And then all of a sudden I see her where, like, people start tagging you, that's how it works. Yeah, and then yeah, I was like, damn, they,
it's like they know,
they you, took them, you know, before they were out of the dryer, so yeah. I only saw them in the wash because they only had that much time, so I didn't even know what they looked like. And then I was like, they look really bad from what I can see. And the girl, like, came really quick and, like, grabbed them. And I was like, uh-oh. Like, she was, like, intimidating. And then all of a sudden she's wearing it. And I was like, whoa. Like, Beyonce yeah. probably had so many pairs of jeans that she could have worn. And she wore those. Okay. We did a good job. Yeah.
All right, vlog. Just finished up with Left Hand. Super dope interview. Expect that very soon. She's a very dope designer. You already know. Got her shit on Rihanna. Beyonce, just mad people, mad, just do major things. So just walking down the street, about to go head to On Some Shit, chill out, thinking about purchasing a kendama, because I haven't really ever, you know, just thinking about it, like, you know, something to, like, kind of relax, enjoy the time, you know, escape from the hustle and bustle, and you know, excuse to go to the store. See if Adam's there, say what's up. I did hear they're interviewing Diplo today, so, you know, who knows, maybe run into Diplo. Be crazy. Vlog out.
We just stayed connected, and then Lana's girlfriend, Kate, actually runs, like, a makeup studio in the other room. The girl that I said what's up to in the elevator is this girl, Britt, or she goes by Dom Pigeon, it's spelled like Dan Pigeon. She does, like, merchandising, and she's in the other room, so, like, our founders are one, two, myself, the dance instructor, and Kate, who does the makeup studio. And then we have, like, a merchandiser, we have, like, a painter, writer, visual artist, we have a model manager, this guy Story, who manages, like, a bunch of different models, and, like, he does merchandising, too. And then we have, who else do we have?
Now they're, like, everything.
Yes, exactly. So we're the Dimension Collective. The whole point is, like, we're celebrating dimensionality in artists, so people who don't just do one thing. So you can come for here for a one-stop shop if you're trying to put together any kind of project. So, like, let's say you need, like, music for a commercial, right? You can go to Kate to, like, to do the makeup for your commercial. You need actual, like, audio, you come to me, I'll do production and, like, scoring for commercials. You come here and it's like, Lana does Artemis Consulting, so let's say there's, like, a social issue you want to touch on, you seek, like, professional advice, and then if you, like, depending on whatever, like, alley you're trying to get into, so let's say you're trying to do, like, homelessness, right, she'll be your Artemis Consultant, and to find an organization that is, like, about legitimately making an impact in the homeless community, and then she'll connect you in that commercial to that market. So it's like, yeah, so you come here and you get, like, all the pieces of what you need to do, whatever it is you're trying to do. Which is really dope. And then it's also, like, right in the heart of fucking downtown.
Yeah.
It's uber lit.
Holy shit.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. He owns the building.
Yeah.
Try to look out in the moonlight.
Dude, this piece right here really reminds me of another piece that's, like, up right now in Boyle Heights.
Yeah.
There's, like, literally, this lady took thousands, like thousands of stuffed animals and just, like, put them in this space.
Damn.
It's fucking nuts. And there's, like, all this fucking demonic music going on.
Shit.
It's wild. There's, like, literally, like, boats suspended from the ceiling, like, filled with ammo.
They have, like, a dance collective crew, you know what I mean? So, like,
when did you do that? I just did this.
I was like, I was gonna say,
I'm my hair.
I turn around and I just see you, like,
the trip, how we ended it. You already know. Duncan Gang. Mass, here we come. You told me I'm a boy and you need a man. Well, no.
too good. I guess I didn't do too good. No, I guess I didn't do too good. Guess I didn't do too good. No, I guess I didn't do too good. I guess I didn't do too good.